all Kerbal Engineer. You better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Flosswap Dance is coming to town. He's making a ship, he's checking it twice. Gonna find out if it'll fly real nice. Flosswap Dance is coming to town. He sees you when you're streaming. He knows if you make mistakes. He knows if your language is bad or good, so be good for the community's sake. So, you better install Kerbal Engineer. Better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das Valdez is coming to town. He knows if you use MechJab. He knows if you have fins. He spends 4 hours on fashion lights just to crash
so ridiculous.
So, you better install
so absolutely
engineer.
Ridiculous.
You better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper.
Is what that is.
Das Valdez is coming.
I fixed that. And then it didn't stick, which gets on my nerves. That's not me singing. That's definitely not me singing. Who knows what the deal with that was? I don't know what the deal with that was. Where is this at? That looks better. That right there looks better. Why can't I hear myself? That's too loud. That's better. That's good. That's good. I think all this is working. So apparently I was trying to get that video to play correctly, and it didn't play correctly. I resized it like 10 times, and apparently whenever I told it to play again, it didn't actually stick. This is what happens sometimes, I guess. What is going on, everyone? I see clouds too. I have Mater to thank for that. Mater, who came in with a raid at the very beginning of the stream. I'm missing stuff over here that needs to be here. Yeah, my shoulder always gets chopped off a bit. What can you do about it? I'm getting situated. I'm getting situated. You will beg, if there is any holiday cheer in your heart, you will beg Nubius to sing the Dasmus Carol on stream. You will beg him. Beg, I say. Nice, Noah. I will definitely do it. Mater, thank you for the Kickstart raid. I wasn't even started streaming yet, and you already raided me, which I appreciate. Folks, you need to click on Mater's name. Wait. There's no chat! How can I point at chat? I can fix this. Hang on. Oh, why is all this stuff turned off? Why is this turned off? Then this needs to be turned on. Then the follower notify needs to be turned on. Nah, bootcamp's already started. We don't need that. We're not doing FTL. That doesn't make any sense. Donation, chat, intro. Okay, we've done that. My hunger is overriding my common rating sense. Dude, Mater, I got no problem with you coming to my channel. Early, late, whatever it is, man. I appreciate it. If you can't see it, you probably can't hear me, but refresh anyways. Just guess where the chat is on our screens. It's over here in this boxish. There's Mater again. All right. Yeah, go get you some rocket fuel, Mater. Get you some rocket fuel. Let me do this. I've got to bring the chat up right quick. It's in a different window. I'm sorry, but your chat is in another castle, window, whatever. Where's my link? Okay, there's me. I'm going to listen to me for just a second. And stop. Okay, that's good. Is the sound good? I don't know. Tell me if the sound's good. This is actually the Renaissance pack, and I'm still trying to tweak it. Mater had clouds, and I was like, dude, Mater, I covet your clouds. I checked the Bible. There was no commandments that said that I couldn't covet Mater's clouds. So I coveted them pretty severely, actually. And then I got them working, and I needed to take some textures out because I didn't really want them. Some of the other textures that I needed, so I needed to fix that. I gotta pop this out. Let's see here. Pop out, please. There you go. Folks, welcome to Boot Camp. You know what I do every other Saturday. I run Kerbal Boot Camp. That needs to come on. Wait a second. Aha! Look how ugly that is. Let me fix it. Okie dokie. Okay, that looks good. Okay, that looks good. Wait. Okay, that looks good. That looks good. And then the top apparently needs to be a little taller, I guess. No, that's not good. Well, that's not going to work. And then I got to do this number. It's always like setting up streams with Das Valdez every time I get started. There we go. That fixes that. Did I miss anything else? No, that needs to be down or up. Silver Bootcamp is definitely recorded. You can go to YouTube. I just put a bunch of videos up there on YouTube. What did Convio say? Just one second, Convio, just one second. That there. Oh, nope. That's not good. Wait. Nah. I really need to fix this better. I'm so terrible. This does not appear to have started with a sad tune. It did. Rogi, it totally started with a sad tune. You're here too rarely now. Folks, toss Convio. A. Follow. Mater as well. Right tackle. Shh. Right tackle. Congratulations, by the way. But shh. Moving right along. I've got that. I've got my chat. I've got this. Foxlayer, we are playing. Welcome to my stream. It's getting spooled up. It's getting spooled up right now. People and folks and other shenanigan-y stuff. I am Dos Valdez. We are going to be doing a Kerbal Boot Camp. Let me make sure the title's correct and all that sort of stuff. Refresh for me. Excellent. Refreshing for me. That's what I like. What am I going to teach people today? Today I'm going to teach people to get into space as if they've never played Kerbal Space Program. I'm going to drink me some delicious Dr. Pepper. We're going to load up the game. We're going to learn all about Kerbal Space Program. We're going to learn how to get into space. We're going to learn about thrust to weight. We're going to learn about delta V. We're going to learn launch profiles. We're going to learn about orbiting. We're going to learn about going to the moon. We're going to learn about not spamming my channel with highlight commands. Ah, yes. That is what we're going to be doing today. So, I've got a couple other things. Just a couple things. We're going to let this get spooled up. I don't want to get into the meat of the program until I've got lots of people here in the channel. So we are going to... I'm going to put a few videos up. Literally, like, 65 two-hour videos. Yes, I did upload 60... I uploaded, like, what, 130 hours of video to YouTube last night. That's what I was doing. Treasy the boss, it's credits. What else do we have? Yes. We need a bottle fuel tank mod. We really did. Emmer, what's going on? Foxlayer, chill out just a little bit for me. We're going. I'm glad you're psyched about it. I'm glad you're here at boot camp. Shimmy the JJ. Yeah! Doss, dude, what's going on? All right, Fox. That is spammy. Cut it. Oh, no! Somebody got a misclick. I got the right one there. Gene, no. Somebody untimeout Gene. Friendly fire. Dude, of course, Mater. Dude, you know you're welcome. You know you're welcome to link up stuff in my channel. We are getting spooled up, folks. We are getting spooled up. We're going to do the boot camp here. We are going to do the boot camp. Get Shimmy a link as well. Shimmy, get Shimmy a link. How to work a keyboard. I have no clue. I'm the last person to ask about that. I'm just like... bang my head against it, and I look up in the rockets in space, and I look at the camera, and it's like, wait, what? How did that happen? There's Shimmy. Folks, give Shimmy a follow. Give Mater a follow. Give... who else is here? I saw Convio come through. We probably have... there is Captain Flapjack, dude. Captain Flapjack, glad you could make it. Who else do we have here that streams? Certainly not Foxlayer. I don't think he streams. He likes to spam. Take care, Dos. Take care, Chet. Take care, Sarion. Cuckoo fies away. Take it easy, egg killer hamster. Who else do I have in my stream? Sapphire Orchid, what's going on? I use OBS. Zetus 2006. Sleepy Hipster Space Travel, greetings. Greetings, glad you made it. I'm going to teach people. I answered that one, I think. Aha! Got distracted watching Dos. Look back at the game. Just enough time to do a suicide burn. Don't let chat kill you. Don't let chat kill you, Eon Raptor. There's Convio. You need to know how to launch KSP. Didn't. You know something? I think for Christmas, I'm going to give all my trolls a Christmas present, and I'm going to do a help desk where I only answer trolly questions like, Dos, can you land on Jewel? Dos, can you go to the sun? Dos, can you leave the solar system? I think for Christmas, I'm going to a stream next week where I only answer trolly questions. Valison, what's going on? Ah, yes. You might be here, but no promises. There are hobbits to be found. Why are you looking for hobbits? I don't know what that means, even. Let me see if there's anything else. I am recording the boot camp. They're going to get uploaded to YouTube if you want. Convio was going off to work. There was also Rogi. Uh-oh, I'm supposed to be in space. Not at boot camp, though. Not at boot camp. Plexi Stan's still doing his 12-hour stream. Yes, yes, I can divide by zero. I can. The calculator says error. It's like, what? Error. Das, Das, do you even lift weight? Look at how huge my arm is. I totally lift. I hope this is like the keyframe. I'm just going to hold this for like 10 minutes until it becomes a keyframe. If you keep the bottom of your arm, streamer, right? Streamers, pay attention. If you keep the bottom of your arm off the camera, it looks like you have huge muscles. Can you fly to Eve with only barefoot on the keyboard? Probably. Yeah, exactly. If I do a troll screen, no trolls will come. Donate them a ticket to join your cry fuel. C-fail. That's close enough. Make sure we... Oh, Pathadre as well. Give Pathadre a link. Give Pathadre a link. Yes, you can get your house on Elu. Top Hat Dragon, I will give you your house on Elu. We will crash into the sun. We will land on Jewel. We'll have an entire stream where we only answer trolley questions. So save them for that stream, please. Save them. Show them the gun show. Thunder and lightning. All right. I have one or two more administrative things to do here before we get started. Before we get started. Jewel is a gas giant. That's why you can't land on it. You'll probably explode. A couple of streams ago, you used to be able to land on... Capture Kerbal and land it on Jewel. Yes, I'm going to use the claw, and I'm going to claw Kerbal, and I'm going to land it on Jewel. Then we're going to have... Two stars. We're gonna have two stars. Sarian, is it in a thing over here? I've got a couple administrative things I've got to do. I am feeling to better. I am feeling to better. Oh wait, I am feeling better today. I've got that. I've got this. Boot camp is spooling up. Man, I gotta drink me some delicious Dr. Pepper. Just a second, Darway. What's up? I'm legit drinking that. You can totally see my Adam's apple. I had one of the kids in one of my after-school programs say, Space Cowboy, Space Cowboy, why do you have that thing in your neck? And I was like, what do you mean, what do I have that thing in your neck? What are you even talking about? How old are you, kid? And the kid was like, well, I'm a kindergartner. And I was like, oh, yeah, you're a kindergartner. Apparently, I've got that going on for me. So I don't know what the deal is. This is the beginning of the stream. I just got online. I mean, I was online before this. I usually don't go offline, but whatever. Should be able to get this week's homework up in a contract, too, once we're ready. That will be absolutely amazing, Sarian. Let me see that. Oh, heck yeah. Perform the following and screenshot once completed. Kerbal Space Academy Boot Camp Homework. We're going to have mods. We're going to have mods even. Dude, Sarian, that looks amazing. That looks amazing. We are going to have some homework. You can use what you learned at boot camp, and if you complete the homework and bring a screenshot back to my channel, you'll actually get extra credits. That's what's going on. These are not the new headphones. These are not the new headphones. They are not here yet. That's no Adam's apple. It's a space station. I don't have a degree, Larry J. I dropped out of college. I did drop out of college when the dot-com boom happened, and then I had that or equivalent experience for a long time. Space station at the edge of the universe. We have to do that. Does Dr. Pepper? Yeah, my Dr. Pepper exploded on me last night. We are. I'm doing good, Wiz. We're spooling up the stream, folks. We're spooling up the stream. We're going to give people a little bit of time to get in here, probably another 8 minutes when we start with content proper. I'm going to be doing some stuff here. I'm going to be trying to read chat. Did I put the channel title correctly? Kerbal Boot Camp. Learn to make orbit before Christmas. I think that that was what it was. Silver, MZ, and a bunch of numbers. S3X Gamer, I'm so far. I don't know what this says. Hang on a second. I'm going to have to read this one. I am. Maybe that's EM. Sofa_king_. Just a second. Stupid. You have the weirdest Twitch username. Why do you have such a weird Twitch username? Anyways, thanks for the follow. Again, I deal with kindergartners every day. Come on, you have nothing on their trolling skills. Crown Aces. Mods are good to go. Mods are being uploaded left, right, front, and center. It's so great. You have to leave. Be back, agent. Be back soon. Better call the medics. Monev's SSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSSS got it. It's not my first rodeo. People act like I just woke up. Actually, I did just wake up. Oh, man. You're going to have to do better than that. Remember that guy last night, that Mike Hunte or whatever that guy's name was? I don't remember that guy's name, but they try. They keep trying. They keep trying, and it just doesn't work. We are spooling up boot camp. Man, we are spooling up boot camp. I've got two more things to do. We've got 7 more minutes until I start boot camp proper. I appreciate you being here. I appreciate you loving space and science and technology and STEM stuff. That's what I do. Maintain eye contact. 3, silver 26. And thanks for watching Brain Fried as well. You were on Brain Fried stream earlier, I know. I appreciate you being there. I need to get my admin stuff done. We'll just start the stream off with that so people can't complain. I am actually going to retweet the stream. Sticky Keys, man, watch your language, please. I would appreciate it if you keep it family friendly on my language. On my stream. Because I've got a whole heck of a lot of families and kids and younger people that watch my stream so they can get excited about space, so they can learn about orbital mechanics and that sort of stuff. So please watch it. Watch the language. Keep it classy on my channel. I'd appreciate it. I really did appreciate it. Thank you, Sticky Keys, man. Thank you. He tried to help me with the moon quest. Excellent. He tried to help you with the moon quest. Silver, I'm going to help you with the moon quest as well. Free build, Kratolaus. It is going to be free play. It's going to be free play. What was that beautiful tune that graced my ears? Could it be? What is the Dr. Pepper ting? It reminds me to drink. It is from Robin Hood. Boromakat. Hello, what is going? West Side Yo. What's shaking? Plexi Raid. Wait, what? Glubo the Mad. Plexi still got a few hours to go. He's not allowed to raid me. He's not allowed to raid my channel. Twitch Terms of Service. I hereby prevent him from raiding my channel. We've got another 5 minutes until boot camp starts. If I had the time, I would put it up on the thing. But I don't. That's a waffle. Dude, Kratolaus, do you know Giant Waffle? Because I'm about to tweet at Giant Waffle and tell him the boot camp is starting. It's any drink with a Dr. Pepper sticker on it. No, it's not Steven Seagal. So we are going to learn to go to space here. First, I need to do a couple things. I need to make sure that I can find this. I need to make sure that I can go over here. If you want to retweet, I did just tweet out that boot camp was starting up. Learn to make orbit before Christmas. That is what I just tweeted out. I'm actually going to retweet that at a couple different places right now. Let me see what is going on here. And we've got, like I said, letting people come into the stream. We've got another 4 minutes before boot camp goes. We've got another 4 minutes before I start boot camp proper. Wow, we've been going for 16 minutes. Ah, yes. Ah, yes. We are going to the moon today. That is what we're doing. I'm going to hop off of chat for just 1 second. So I can get that administrative work done. And I can do this. And I can do... What is Giant Waffle's Twitter? Because I did want to tweet it out and let him know that I was going to be doing this, because I really do appreciate him streaming KSP. I was watching him quite a bit. It's really like a situation where his chat, he's so popular, his chat goes so fast that you can't really say anything in it, right? But let me see here. Twitter.com. Just go to his channel, actually. That'll bring it up. That will bring it up. Where is the search? Let's see what I got here. Ah, excellent. Let's see. There's that. I think that's his logo, I think. He's at the Giant Waffle, apparently. What an interesting place to be, at the Giant Waffle. Where is... Okay, that's good. So I definitely said that I was going to tweet that out to him. And I'm going to do like this. We are letting people come in to the stream before I get in this proper. Thermal space program. The Kerbal Space. Yeah, there we go. There we go. The Kerbal Space Academy Boot Camp is spooling up. I'm not reading chat right now. And then, yeah, it's Saturday. There we go. I'm interested in learning. That's gonna be too many thingies. Yeah, that's way too much. That's way too many thingies. I have no clue what I'm doing, by the way. Just one second. New braid. Just new. Ah, yes. New braid with Tesla Max as well. Excellent. And we are going to get going. We've got just another minute or two, and we are going to get going. I really did appreciate him doing that, though. Ah, yes. There we go. Okay. That's just too many. There you go. Learning. But I won't have room for. Yes. Now, TVs and John's phone does. You know I'm going to get started, y'all. You know you have to be patient with me. I'm hanging out. I'm letting people get here before I start the content. Keep it classy. Keep it all those sorts of things. There you go. There you go. That's going to work. Is that going to be too much? Ah, that's just going to be too much. That's working. That's okay. That looks fine. That looks fine as well. There you go. See, that works. That works. That's perfect. There. See, that's perfect. Look at that. Got it. That's fine. I love it. Right there. Okay. Let's send this out. Done. Done deal. That's Nubius right there. What did I just say? Where is that Evan at? I said Nubius whenever he came in. There we go. I did that. That's fine. We are letting things get spooled up. If you want to retweet and that sort of stuff, you are welcome to do it. I don't know how to actually put a retweet link up, so you just have to go to my Twitter and then click on retweet or whatever. This is your fourth boot camp. You're getting used to this. Oh, we are getting going. Nubius made it in. I'm going to get caught up with chat for just a second. Of course you can. Of course you can, Sleepy Hipster. Go for it. Leaky Brains, what's shaking? Nubius Maximus, thank you for the raid. When will you show how to go to the moon? That's what we're doing at boot camp. Remember, boot camp runs 6 to 8 hours, so be patient. I will stream as if you've never played the game before. I'll show you everything. Omaha TV, what's shaking? Folks, Nubius. Hey, if you missed it at the beginning of the stream, since Nubius is here now, let's do this again. I do sleep. Wait, oh my gosh. Ah! Earthworm Slim, did we get Slim as well? I was paying attention in another window and Earthworm Slim came through. Make sure Slim got a link. Make sure Slim got a wink. It's free build. Very early in career. Yes, Zetus. Yes. You will be able to use. I build simpler rockets in boot camp. I don't use all the wacky unlocked parts and that sort of stuff. Captain Flapjack! Helping people learn science while learning how to launch some green things into space. I have caught myself staring at the stars after work now. You do a great job. Captain Flapjack, thank you for that. I appreciate you. That one came through. That one definitely came through right there, man. I really do appreciate the support. For anybody wondering, this is my job. This is what I do. I develop curriculum for Kerbal Space Program, and I teach classes in it. Curriculum. But this is my job, and I'm able to do it because of people like Captain Flapjack who just tossed that donation in there. Flapjack, I really do appreciate it. Thank you for the support, man. Let me do this, and then we are going to get going. Nubius, you're awesome. First off, you're way awesome. I need to do this. Shh. It's awful quiet in my sky. Let me do this.
gotta drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das Valdez is coming to town. He's making a ship, he's checking it twice. Gonna find out if it'll fly real nice. Das Valdez is coming to town. He sees you when you're streaming. He knows if you make mistakes. He knows if your language is bad or good. So be good for the community's sake. So, you better install a Kerbal Engineer. Better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das Valdez is coming to town. He knows if you use MacJab. He knows if you like business. He spends 4 hours on fashion lights just to crash it in.
Mid-song!
So, you better install a Kerbal Engineer. You better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das Valdez is coming. Das Valdez is coming. Das Valdez is coming to town.
Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing? That was a donation from Glubo the Mad. Glubo the Mad, your donation came through when the video scene was up, which doesn't have the donation notify. Glubo the Mad, thank you so much for the support. It was a donation that said, good luck, have fun, from Glubo the Mad. And it came through just whenever that happened. Oh my gosh, Glubo, thank you so much for the donation. I really do appreciate it. Glubo the Mad, there you go. Spartan's got it. Let's turn chiptunes back on. That's going. There's another one. That one came up. R2B anime. Go get a pack of Dr. Pepper. I'm going to just be able to build a house out of Dr. Pepper. I'm going to be able to build a house out of Dr. Pepper. I really do appreciate it. R2B anime as well. Guys, I appreciate it. Let's get going with Kerbal Boot Camp. Let's get going with Kerbal Boot Camp. It's about that time. It's about that time to get going. R2B anime, Glubo the Mad, and Captain Flapjack. Guys, what a way to start a stream. I'm just a big talking head right now. I could be on CNN or whatever. Don't drink your entire house. I would replace it with empty bottles. Actually, I have almost enough empty bottles over there to actually start a foundation of a house. That is amazing. That is amazing. That is definitely what we're going to do. But we're ready to get going with boot camp here. We are ready to get going with boot camp. Cadets, I'm glad you're here. If you're interested in Kerbal Space Program, if you want to learn how to play the game, if you see all the awesome things that happen on YouTube and that happen on KSPTV and that happen here on Twitch and that happen on the forums and you see these screenshots and you see this amazing stuff that everybody does and you're like, man, there's no way I could ever do that. I'm here to prove you wrong. You can do awesome stuff in Kerbal Space Program. You really can. There are some simple concepts, and once you get the simple concepts, you'll be able to get stuff into orbit. You'll be able to go to the moon. You'll be able to go to other planets, Duna, Jewel, Dress, for whatever reason you want to go there. You'll be able to do that stuff if you hang out with my Kerbal Space Academy streams. Every weeknight at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, I do a Kerbal Space Academy stream where I focus on a specific topic. I teach you how to make a space plane. I teach you how to get into orbit. I teach you how to balance craft. I teach you how to dock and rendezvous, go to other planets, do interplanetary transfers, plot and execute them, design space stations, design bases you land on other places. Every night I do a different stream where I focus in depth. Every other Saturday I do what we're doing right now, Kerbal Boot Camp, where I start the game from scratch and I talk as if I've never played the game before. Maybe not as if I've never played the game before. I've talked as if you've never played the game before. And we are trying to see how to do things like build a rocket, get into orbit, understand the basic concepts, thrust to weight, delta V, the launch profile, all the things that you need to do. That's what we do at boot camp. Then tomorrow I'm going to be doing Kerbal Help Desk. You can come to my stream. You can ask me questions. You can upload craft. I'll load the craft into my game. I'll help you debug things. I'll demonstrate things. Whatever it is you're looking for, that's what I do. That's what I do. I love to get people excited about the game. I love to play the game, clearly. I've been talking way too much, so let's get started in boot camp right here. Let's get over into here. I'm going to start a new game. I am going to just go ahead and start a new one, because today is Kerbal Boot Camp Day. And I got my flag in there. Excellent. And then we're going to be... let's just do KSA Boot Camp. What is today? 2014-12-20. That's so that it sorts. Sandbox. I do start in sandbox mode. I recommend that you start in sandbox mode. It makes you not have to worry about things like Kerbal experience and farming science and money and that sort of stuff. I do recommend you start in sandbox mode. Don't be Don't be intimidated by the number of parts you get. Stick with the smaller parts like I'm going to do right here. But Kerbal Boot Camp 2014 1220 Sandbox Mode. Difficulty doesn't matter in Sandbox. Let's get this party started. I'm going to drink some delicious Dr. Pepper. If I had any waffles, I would love to eat some delicious waffles. But I don't have any waffles. Anyways, what I'm going to do, here's what we're going to do. I am going to do a quick mission out to the moon. I'm going to show you what I'm going to teach you the rest of the stream. If you're interested in learning any of the stuff, I am going to go over everything that I do in detail. But for now, I'm going to put together a very quick moon mission, and then I'm going to circle back and I'm going to go over every part of that moon mission in detail. Building the rocket, why I did what I did, how I decided the rocket needed to be that way, how I launched it, how I transferred to the moon, how I landed. I'm going to go over all of those things, but first I'm going to show you what you can learn if you stick with the stream. Welcome to the Space Center. Yes, Gene. You're Gene Kerman, flight director and your guide for this quick introduction. This is the Space Center. From here, you can do all sorts of stuff. I'm going to get going. I don't need to launch anything yet because I need a rocket first. I don't need to go to the tracking station because I've got nothing in orbit. R&D, everything's unlocked. I don't need to hire any astronauts. I don't need to build a space plane. I don't need any contracts. And I don't need whatever this building does. Give swimming lessons or whatever it is. Let's see here. I did update my title. I'm good to go. Let's see here. I'm going to open this up. You cannot see me. There we go. Let's go to the game. Now you can see me. Everything's good. That is streaming the desktop, so let's fix that right quick. That is what we ended with last night. Broop. There we go. Now I'm good to go. All right. Excellent. I'm still a big head. I know. We just fixed it. Close. KSA cadets. There we go. Can you see me now? Alright, so here we are. Chip tunes are good. This is go. Alright. I'm going to toss together a rocket very quickly. I am very quickly going to toss together a rocket here. It was probably because I was in full stream and doing all sorts of stuff. So let me put this together right quick. I am going to need a pod on my rocket. I am going to go over this in detail again. I am definitely going to need a chute so my Kerbal doesn't have a high velocity impact experience when he returns to Kerbal. Kerbin, actually. I'm going to need a stack decoupler so we don't have to waste a bunch of time. I'm going to need a fuel tank. That's important. Let's just go with this fuel tank. Basic Moonlander design here. Again, I'm going to go over all of this in detail. For now, I am just slapping together a little rocket. Who was that? Because teachers nowadays are underpaid. Lego Master, I agree with you. I am not a teacher. I don't think that I should be qualified to be called a teacher, actually, because teachers put up with a lot more than I do. But I really do appreciate the support. Thank you so much, Lego Master 14, for the donation. They're underpaid. They really are. I'm going to need a dorsal battery. So let's toss a dorsal battery on there right quick. This new part sorting. That's just one battery. That should be enough to get me to the moon and back. Solar panels would be good. If you don't have solar panels, you could totally put more batteries on here. I am going to need an engine. We'll just go with the 909, an engine you get very early in the game. There you go. Let's check to make sure my... Yep, that was looking good. Okay. Anything else? I'm not going to worry about a ladder or anything like that. We're just keeping it simple here. Let's make more stages. I'm going to need something that can actually push me out to the moon. And I know from experience that it takes me about 1170, about 1070 delta V to get a transfer to the moon, which usually means that one of these tanks plus one of these engines. Gene! Merry Christmas to you too, man. Merry Christmas, Doss. Let's see how long the train runs today. Gene, I appreciate you adding a $30 car to the donation chain. Thank you so much for the support. It's not the first time you've done that. Probably not going to be the last time. I really do appreciate you. Thank you so much for the support, Gene. Dude, that's awesome. Moving right along in Gene's honor, that's going to be my Mooner Kicker stage. I'm also going to need some way to get off the launch pad into orbit. That usually looks a little bit like this. You can see my Delta V ticking up here. I'm going to explain what I'm looking at. I know just on the bounce and by the numbers right here that stage is going to put me to the moon simply because I'm looking at that number. I know that this stage is going to be able to land on the moon and take off again simply because I'm looking at this number. I'm going to teach you all about the numbers and how they work whenever we get going here. My kicker stage usually looks like this. That looks good. This is a great engine for that stage, the LVT-45. That's a great looking kicker stage. I will take it. I would then toss in a very quick lifter stage that looks like this. the lifter stage itself. Ding, ding, ding. And we're going to need one of these tanks. I've built this rocket before. You know that I normally don't have a script to my boot camps, right? I normally do my boot camps from scratch. I do them on the bounce and by the numbers. This one I've built before, because we're going to take it to the moon right quick, then I'm going to come back here and I'm going to teach you why I built it this way. This one's not quite in orbit yet. This one's not quite in orbit. How do I know? I played a couple hours of Kerbal Space Program, first off. And I also can look at the numbers here and know that that number's not 4,000. Until that number's 4,000, I know that kicker's not going to get me into orbit. I know that that kicker's not going to get me into orbit. That's looking better. 2.03 thrust weight on the pad. That's usually something that I look for. That right there gets me into orbit. 1.88 on the pad. Actually, a little bit more fuel. When I've got excessive thrust weight, I always add more fuel. 3938, a drummer boy will do it. 4025, that right there is a recipe for orbital success. I know that this rocket will go into orbit because that number right there is over 4,000. If my kicker, if my lifter plus my kicker is over 4,000 when in Kerbal Engineer Atmospheric Mode, what's Kerbal Engineer? I'm going to actually show you how to install it and what it does and teach you how to use it. But I know by the numbers that if that number is over 4,000, this rocket's going into space. So let's toss some pale Merry Christmas, DOS. A little thank you for teaching us. Pale. Which pale? I've got two pales. Which pale? I appreciate you. Pale horse? Pale Iran? Pale. Which pale? You didn't show me which pale it was. Say something in chat and tell me. I'm going to go look for your name. All right, we are going to be good here. Let me put these struts in. I am going to put just a little bit of struts like this. You don't need the nose cones. They're just for fashion. I'll talk all about that as well. That right there looks great. I shouldn't actually need the separatrons, but I am going to put them on there. You probably won't need these separatrons, but I am going to put them on there just to make sure that this rocket clears correctly. We are going to talk about that as well whenever we get to building the rocket. How does that look? Is it pretty? Oh, so pretty. It sure as heck ain't symmetrical, and that makes my eye twitch. That is almost good. Yeah, that looks pretty. I'm going to check the staging right quick. I'm going to toss some launch clamps on it, and we are going to go on our way to the moon. So I've got some launch clamps. There you go. They also provide electric charge, in case you were wondering. Notice these engines are different. Do you see how that engine has a little bit smaller nozzle? These are bigger, more beefy looking. I'll tell you why that is as well. I am going to show you all of this stuff. I am absolutely going to show you all of this stuff in great detail. But first, I want to get you salivating about what you can accomplish after watching this stream. Staging, good to go. That's good to go. That's good to go. Let's check it. Booster stages, go. Main stage, go. Launch clamps, go. Second stage, eject booster stages, go. Separation motors, go. Third stage. Oh, yep, third stage. Orbital kicker stage, go. Actually, lunar kicker stage, go. Yeah, I actually have seen some information. Nose cones have no effect. Gangrene TVP nose cones in stock KSP have no effect other than to make your rocket have less delta V. Your rocket will be slower, your rocket will have less thrust to weight, and your rocket will have less delta V because nose cones are cosmetic, donations are awesome, and extra weight. They don't provide any aerodynamic help. Let's see here. Did someone say donation train? Merry Christmas, sir. Keep up the awesome streams. Thank you, EPD2005. I appreciate you. I'm aware that the chat's in way of the staging. I move the chat whenever I do the staging out there. I'm just tossing this rocket up to the moon right quick. This is the KSA Boot Moon Quick Rocket. Boot Moon Quick Rocket. Go. I feel like it needed another word. Go. That looks good. All right, let's save it. We've got this, we've got that, there's another one, Nubius, Maximus, Rope, Subscription, Donation, Train, Hype, update your setup picture on the donation page. Oh, I do need to update my setup picture, I do have more monitors now. Nubius, thank you for that, dude, but I'm gonna refund you, I think, because you made me that awesome Christmas song. You made me the DOS Valdez is Coming to Town Christmas song, man. You don't have to put in $4.99, but I appreciate you nonetheless, dude. I do. I'm coming to your channel, and I'm going to double that. I'm going to double that on your own channel. Anything else? I think we're good to go. Let's get this rocket out to the moon. I'm going to save it. I'm going to launch it. And let's see what we've got here. Come on, Kerbal Engineer. Kerbal Crown Aces. I ain't going to out anybody. Let's see here. I ain't going to out anybody. We've got old Jebediah Kerman in there. Don't worry about the textures. That was something I was working on. I am going to... Ooh, that monoprop. I hate it when monoprop hitches a ride in my rocket when I'm not using monoprop. Chat, why didn't you tell me to take the monoprop out? They do make your rocket look cool. I agree that they do make your rocket look cool. You there, monopropellant. I'm not using you. Get out of my rocket. Why? Look at my Delta V, 7170. Oh, it's going up. Wow, not taking that monoprop got me what? 44 extra Delta V? Don't take it if you're not going to use it. You just don't need it. Get out of my rocket, monoprop. Rob Sonic 2. Hey, Doss. Been watching for a few days and have learned a lot. I just got KSP. Heck yeah. And today is the day I finally get to orbit. Rob Sonic, man, if you want to open up your game and play along with me, if you run into questions, ask them in chat. Say the word question in it. It'll highlight it in red. You see that happening. I'm a terrible weather. Man, you see it happening, right? Ask me a question if you need any help. Veru plays. Choo-choo. Donation train. Hype. Merry Christmas. Doss, put some DP under the tree. I think I'm just going to, like, decorate my entire tree with, like, Dr. Pepper bottles. I'm just going to, like, put a little cord around it, a little hook, and I'm going to hook it on the tree. That's like, all I have in my entire living space is Dr. Pepper bottles. Not really kidding. But thank you, Veru Plays, for the donation. This is my job. This is what I do for a living, and I appreciate you letting me do it. Let me do this. Shang can pull the side of the ship through a test tube towards the front when flying in an atmosphere. Specific tank, they don't. They definitely don't. Trust me on that. They definitely don't. If you see it pulling it, it's because of the extra weight. It's not because of anything aerodynamic. Serious question. Is kicker stage? Yes, I have seen the term kicker stage used in official NASA communications, Tesla Max. I have seen that. We have this. I need to send it back out of the pad. Let's launch it. It's time to launch this. Take monoprop out of the... Take the monoprop out of the bottles before you hang them. There's the DP fuel tank. I've actually got a DP mod if you want to use it. We are good to go. Panel lock looking good. All right, throttle up. Panel lock, SAS engaged. That makes the rocket go straight, or at least continue to go straight when it's currently going straight. Do a final check here. I'm going to do a final check. Launch clamps, go. Main stage, go. Booster stage, go. SEP motors, go. SEP decouple, go. We've got kicker stage. That's the Mooner kicker stage. Decouple, go. Mooner kicker stage, engine, go. Lander decouple, go. Lander kicker, go. Lander engine, go, actually. Road home, go. And the shoot, go. The not crash into the planet, go. Let's go to the moon right quick. Then we're going to come back here, and we're going to start talking about all this. 3, 2, 1. Hey, if you're thinking about trying the game, get the demo. Let's toss a demo link up there. There's a free demo. The full game is so much easier than the demo. 3, 2, 1. Space. I'm going to go up. Straight. Watch how simple this is. Watch this simple launch profile. I guarantee you that if you do this on the bounce and by the numbers, that's a great book, by the way, on the bounce and by the numbers, you will consistently get your rockets to orbit. You will. You simply will. I'm going to go straight up until I get to 10K, 10 kilometers, 10,000 meters, 10 million millimeters. Is that how many millimeters this is? I think it is. I don't know. I grew up in Texas. We don't really have a lot of truck with millimeters on the farm in Texas. I actually did grow up in the middle of a cornfield. I launched a lot of rockets, little SD smaller rockets in my days. Those little wacky AAA engines. The AAA engines that we go, and then you'd never find that rocket again because the entire rocket was like this big. I've got these things. I've got a crash rocket here. Hopefully our rockets don't end up like this, this little bit of a rocketed curve here. I guess it could do an automated gravity turn, but that's not exactly what we want. The clouds are a mod. The clouds are a mod. But pay attention now. We're going straight up until we get to 10K. There we go. We're going to go straight up until we get to 10K. When we get to 10K, we're going to pitch over. We're going to lean our rocket to the east. Why are we going to the east? It's like jumping off of a moving sidewalk. If you're on a moving sidewalk and you're running in the same direction as the moving sidewalk, don't do it in the airport. You might be pulled over by security. But if you're running in the same direction as a moving sidewalk and you run and you jump, you'll be able to jump farther and faster than you would if the moving sidewalk was not moving. Even worse, if the moving sidewalk was going one direction, you were running the other direction, you would jump slower. You would run slower and you would jump less far than if you jumped off in the same direction as the moving sidewalk. Good stage decouple. I love it. That is why we always go to the east. I'm going to go at a 45 degree angle here until I get an apoapse. That is the top point of my orbit right there, of 50. Once I get an apoapse of 50, I'm going to click there to make that safe orbit, and I am going to turn and burn. I'm going to lay this rocket down. Yeah, right there. I am going to lay this rocket down on its side, turn and burn. I'm going to try to get as much orbital velocity as I can. I don't want to go any higher. I don't want to be pointing up anymore. I want to be going around the planet. I know I'm going through this launch fast. I'm going to do so many of these launches today, and I'm going to show you on the bounce and by the numbers how you can get them done. I know I'm going through this one fast because I am showing you. I'm starting off, tell them what you're going to tell them, and then tell them what you're telling them, and then tell them what you told them. Anybody ever take those tests in like elementary school, high school, that sort of stuff? I am going to fly right like this until I get an apoapse. This is Kerbal Engineer. Of 80, and I'm gonna cut the engines. Star Wars lied to you. Star Trek lied to you. Every space show you've ever seen has lied to you. You don't keep burning the engines constantly. Most of space travel is coasting along without using the engines. Let me turn off the atmosphere trajectory mod right quick. Configure visible buttons. I should have done that first. Kerbal alarm clock, planet shine. Okay, okay, good. Now I can do that, and I can turn off trajectories. There you go. Okay, that's what I needed to do. Oh, go away. There you go. All right, don't worry about that. That's a mod. I teach that mod in another class. I'm going to go ahead and go to orbit here. Wow, that's huge. There you go. Let's scroll in. Let's do this. Let's pull that prograde. All I got to do is just pull that prograde until, whoop, I get an orbit. That looks good. Honestly, that's good enough. We're just going to orbit. It doesn't have to be perfect. It doesn't have to be exact. It's not rocket science. It's a rough approximation of rocket science. And you don't have to get it exact to get into space. So right here, I've got a 49-second burn. Round that up to 50. Half it to 25. I always half my burns before and after the node. When this gets to T-minus 25 seconds, I'm going to go full throttle. I'm going to floor it. And we are going to go to space. There was 25. Let's get old engineer out of the way. We don't need it right now. I am going to do this and just burn like this. I know I'm blowing through this. I know I'm Kibo 89. I know that Kibo 89 is awesome because you just sent me the donation. You cannot see me because you're on mobile. That's lame. That's totally lame. I'm sorry that you can't see me. I don't know what I can do about that. Does anybody know what you can do if you can't see me on mobile? I don't know. But thank you for the donation nonetheless. Kibo 89, you are awesome. I really do appreciate it. Got followers coming in as well, guys. I'll get the followers in bulk. I'm just going to keep burning this node right here. I'm going to keep burning this node right here. Let's look at engineer. Let's cut the engine. That's fine, honestly. I'm going to go ahead and toss this stage now. Don't need this anymore. I should have tossed that stage a little earlier, but that's going to be okay. Now I'm in space. I'm in space. I'm in a stable orbit. Check it out. Periapse of 47. I need to burn a little bit more. That's not a stable orbit, Doss, you idiot. You need a periapse of at least 70 to be in a stable orbit. So let's do that. 70. There you go. Now I'm in a stable orbit. If both my apoapse and my periapse, my highest and lowest points from the planet, remember a poo in the periscope? Ah, yes. It is going to make orbital junk. I'm so sad. If my apoapse and my periapse are both above 70, that means I'm in a nice stable orbit. Now I'm going to go to the moon again. I'm going to go back over this in detail, guys. Look at that aurora up there. Where are you at, moon? Look how easy it is to go to the moon. Find the moon. Click on the moon. Set his target. Slap a node down. Add maneuver. Pull on the prograde handle of the node until you are going as high as the moon is. You see that? Look, I'll focus on Kerbin for you. Do you see how we are going to go up to the level of the moon? All that I'm doing right there, I'm pulling on that little green thing until that orbit is right there at the moon. But Das, it's not going to the moon yet. But wait, there's more. Look, I can come over here. I can click here. And I can drag the node around until I get that sweet, sweet lunar encounter. Done! Let's just go. Now I've got that node in. It's going to be a minute 52 second burn. It's coming up in 24 minutes. I'm going to point right there. And I'm going to start the time warp. And let me explain to you why I'm going to half that burn. The node system expects that you're going to be able to apply right there. Look at it. Wait, it's right there. 853 meters per second of delta V all at once. the instant that that note occurs. Rockets don't work that way. It takes the rocket time to put that delta V into your velocity. You, the rocket's going, and you're adding energy, you're adding energy, you're adding energy. It takes time to add that energy, though. In fact, this is telling me it's going to take me a minute and 52 seconds in order to add 853 meters per second of velocity to my orbit. So because it wants me to put it all right at the node, what I do is I half that time. I say, hey, I'm going to take my burn, I'm going to half it, and I'm going to do half my burn before the node, half my burn after the node, so that on average, all of my delta V is applied at the node. That's why we half it. That's why we have it. Every time you do a burn, you should be halving it like that. It's going to make your burns a lot more accurate. It really is. Let me do this. Let me get some follows out of the way. Dark Steven, Kiwiception. You make people think of kiwis? Because that would be a that would be the way it goes. Legit Ninja, Dismo High Ruler, Nikki 1088, Bed Intruder 99, Uber, Sir the Omega, Reed Dunk. Do you have Nike socks on? And Abadabadabadan. Thanks for the follows, y'all. I totally appreciate you. I totally appreciate you. Again, I'm going to half this burn. It's a minute 52. Half of a minute 52 is 30 plus 25 plus 1. So that would be 56. And isn't that pretty? That is pretty right there, y'all. I do have a couple mods installed. If you're interested in my mods, you can scroll down. You can see what I'm using. However, the pretty mods aren't updated yet. The mods in the channel will be able to help you out with the mods that I have. Nice, Gene. I love that quote. So I'm going to do this burn in 56 seconds. 4, 3, 2, Van, there you go. Just point towards the node. Look at that. That is beautiful. B-E-A-utiful is what that is. Yes. Don't spam the quotes too much, guys. But now that I'm pointing at the node, I can go ahead and do this. 20. 10. I got 5. There. 3. Did it. 59, 58, 57, 56. I'm going to light that engine. And watch it what I'm doing. I am burning that engine, and I am adding energy to my orbit. As I add energy to my orbit, do you see that apoapsis increase? Orbits are funny. They're always equal. Down here at the periapsis, I've got two types of energy in my rocket. I've got potential energy, which is represented by my height above the planet, and I've got kinetic energy, which is represented by my speed. Whenever I put more speed into my orbit down here, I actually, on the other end of the orbit, keep the same amount of energy, but it trades. It's in balance. Up there, I will get a higher height, a higher altitude above the planet. What does that mean? When I get up there, I'll be going slower. I'll show you how that works. I'll show you how that works. The important thing now is that I am adding energy to this orbit. There you go, Jeb. Drive for me for a second. I am adding energy to this orbit. I'm changing my situation. My situation was I was orbiting Kerbin in about 80K. I don't want to be orbiting Kerbin anymore. I want to go to the moon. So I'm going to spend energy. I'm going to spend fuel. I'm going to spend delta V to change my situation from low Kerbin orbit, LKO, out to the Mooner Encounter. That is what I'm doing. I'm spending that energy right now. I'm spending that delta V. You can actually see my delta V going down. See that delta V going down? That's the currency of space. For rockets in space, delta V is the lingua franca, whatever. It's the only thing you have to do anything with in space. I am spending that delta V to change my situation from LKO out to the moon. I'm going to keep on burning like that until I get that sweet, sweet Mooner Encounter. Like that. And I'm going to cut the engine. Again, you don't point at the moon and go like that. You don't burn forever. You burn, and then you coast. I just did, a two-second burn, and now I'm going to coast for a day. That's how space travel goes. I see so many new players to the game. I see so many new players to the game constantly burning the engines. They go into orbit, and they're like, man, I saw Star Wars. Those engines are always on. You know, look at the X-Wing fighters. They don't even have to turn around to slow down. They just slow down magically. We don't do it in KSP. That's why the number one destination of new Kerbal's players is the sun. Because they burn their rockets for way too long. That's why everybody always goes into a solar orbit. Let's see how this goes here. Watch as I am now on my Mooner trajectory. I'm on my Mooner transfer orbit here. I'm going from low Kerbin orbit out to the moon. I know I'm not reading chat too much right now. I am going to get this mission done, then I'm going to go all over chat. And by the way, I think when I get this rocket home successfully, I'm going to do a giveaway. I will give away a copy of KSP when this rocket successfully lands back on Kerbin. That is what I will be doing whenever I land back on Kerbin. There we go. We're going to crash into the moon. Apparently, I'm going to crash into the moon. Here we go. Here we go. Gray Rocks Moon, do not call new Kerbal Space Program players noobs in my channel. Please and thank you. This is a place for people to learn the game. We don't make fun of them. We don't call them noobs. We don't say that they're not very good at the game. That gets on my nerves just a little bit. I don't care if you have the wackiest rocket, the weirdest unstable orbit. If you get into orbit for the first time, you come to my channel and you tell me you did it, I'm going to give you a good job, cadet, because that's still an accomplishment. So don't make fun of the noobs. Thank you. I appreciate it. And folks, if you're playing along and you get something accomplished and you want to post up a screenshot of your rocket on the moon or something like that, you can do it. If it's KSP related, if it's family friendly, come back to my channel, give me a mission report. Even if you don't have a screenshot, just say, Dust, I got to the moon for the first time. Do it on my channel. You're welcome to do it. I love it when people come and tell me that they were able to accomplish something. I really do. Now we're in the moon's orbit. Folks, thanks for the follows. I'm going to get them in bulk. I will get them in bulk. Woo, there's me crashing into that moon. That's not looking too good. That's not looking too good, but it should be okay. It should be okay. Wow, those follows coming in all of a sudden. Let's see what we've got here. Dismo High Ruler, Abaddon Smurf, Randar94TV, Bliss9. Bliss9. Does that mean no Bliss? That doesn't sound great. Dublin Lee, Cairo122, Kiba Posts, Dudley Spencer, QWERTY49. It's missing the W. Do you still pronounce it QWERTY if it's Carty? Cutie? Maybe that's Cutie? I don't know. Matt, Captain, thanks for the follow as well. Alright, moving around. Let's see here. Where's the moon? Oh, there it is. Excellent. Let's land on it right quick. I'm just going to go ahead and just time warp here. Maybe I should go into orbit first. Yeah, I'll go into orbit first. Alright, let's do that. I'm going to burn radial out just a little bit. That's radial in. I will explain to you what these terms mean. It's just a point on the nav ball. It's something that's going to deflect or bend my orbit a little bit. I'm actually not wanting to crash into the moon. I would like to go around the moon. So look at what I'm doing. I'm pointing my rocket like that. Notice the orientation of this rocket. Watch what happens when I burn here. Oh, well, all of a sudden I start to bend the trajectory and I no longer crash, come on, into the moon. I now have a 10K periaps. So let's do that. Let's come over here. Let's slap down a maneuver node right quick. Yep, nope, can't. That's okay. Let's just go ahead and get on down to the periaps. Nidersold, you just completed your first OKS space station. Nicely done. There's a good job K for you from Gene. Dude, Gene, thank you for the help. Good job, cadet. Nidersold, I appreciate you. What does Superside do? I'm trying to read it. Superside said, I don't see that one, but let me know. Hazy Gaiman, what's shaking? What's the purple hyperbolic trajectory there? That is my resultant orbit after I leave the moon's sphere of influence. What a dirty cratered moon that is. I'm just coming over here. I'll hit periap soon. There we go. There's that orbital flick. And there's 30. 20. Remember when I added energy to my orbit so that I could leave Kerbin's sphere of influence? What do you think I want to do if I want to not leave the moon's sphere of influence? Right now we've got this sweet gravity slingshot happening. There's that moon. I'm going to go ahead and point retrograde here, just like that. And I am going to take energy out of my orbit now. Watch this. I am going to burn like that, such that I don't go flying past the moon in a slingshot maneuver. That's actually a gravity slingshot, which you can do in KSP. I'm going to slow down so that the sweet, sweet love of the moon can capture me with her gravity. Gravity? Why was I going to say that twice? That doesn't make any sense. But I am going to take that energy out of my orbit by burning retrograde. Again, I'm going to go over all this right there. You playing for the reason what you told me, or helped me achieve it for the first time. Thank you, Orchid. Thank you. I did not scroll up. I just saw somebody say congrats. There you go. A lunar orbit, and all we had to do was slow down a little bit. We're in orbit around the moon now. Why don't we land? That's a pretty looking moon. That is a pretty looking moon. Let's go ahead and land. Why don't we land? Let's do that. I think we should land. I am going to... Is this orbital view? This is a weird sideways orbital view for some reason. There we go. Camera free. Hey, that crater looks nice, doesn't it? Let's land in that crater. Maybe that's something that we want to do today. I'm just going to orient my dorsal side with my dorsal battery up. That's very, very, very important. I will explain why. That crater is looking delicious, so let's go ahead and land in it. I'm just going to start burning retrograde. Wow, that is a beat-up crater, yo. Look at that thing. Huh. Again, look at what's happening with my orbit. That looks like a procedure. Is that a procedural crater? Really? Huh. I'm just burning. Looks like that stage ran out of fuel. Not doing us any good anymore. Let's crash it into the moon. Let's go ahead and continue burning. I'm going to put these gear down as well. Beep, 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 beep. Blunk. There you go. Yeah, this looks like a nice place to land. I think we'll just land right down here. And I am going to do a super simple landing. Any KSP OGs in the house? This is not the most efficient landing. We are on the same page with that. This is the landing that I teach in boot camp. There are more efficient ways to land a rocket. This is not the most efficient way. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to come to a complete stop like this. How's that looking? Are we in the crater yet? Oops, I need to drink some Dr. Pepper. Mm-hmm. I do. I need to wake up. Why do I need to wake up? Doing good, T-Game. Doing good. This looks okay. Yeah, this looks okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to burn like this. Let's see here. Aid of the Devil, I'm going to do this all over again. I am going to do this all over again in great detail. That's why I'm going through it right now. I am going through it a little quickly right now because I'm going to go through every single part of this in great detail. Let's go to surface mode. Uh-huh. Gotcha that time, surface mode. There you go. I just put that green X at the top of the nav ball. I've got it, don't I? Yeah, just burn over so that green X is at the top of the nav ball. See how I burn off to the side and I push that green X around? There you go. Right like that. I guess we're going to land pretty soon. Eh, what's my real altitude? Let's see, what are you telling me? Okay. I need to burn down to, I don't know, like this. Let's just burn some. That looks good. 400, 300, 200. Yeah, that looks fine. Hey, the shadow's a great way to orient your rocket. So let's just go ahead and do this. I'm going to keep that green X. Always, always, always keep that green X at the top of your nav ball, right like that. Where's my shadow? There it is. It's looking good, though. It's looking good. Let's get rid of that. We don't need that anymore. I could actually take a little bit of throttle out of that. I could take a little bit more throttle out of that. Always just orient your rocket so that that's at the top of the nav ball. Again, not the most efficient landing. It's fine. If you get to the moon this way and you come to my channel and you tell me that you landed on the moon for the first time, I am going to say nothing beyond good job, cadet. Screeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee There you go. I found the new controls to be a little bit wacky, but it's pretty good. It's pretty good. We've apparently made it to the moon. Westside, yo, great question. I keep the green X at the top so that I am falling straight down. When that green X is at the top of the nav ball right now, that means that I'm falling straight down. Straight down like that. T-Game, I don't want to talk about that stuff. We're going to keep it simple. So we can learn the basic concepts. Mission, or is this just a mood camping for Bootlamp? This is the mission. That's what we're doing right now. We're going to learn about everything that I'm doing right now. We've got old Jebediah out here. He's going to get out of the rocket. He's going to... Oh, look at that. Look at that. That is pretty right there. Look at that. That is a pretty sight, isn't it? I wish I could see that in real life. Good night, Irene. Did I repair the green screen? Was there something wrong with the green screen? I think I got it good. Yeah. That gets on my nerves the way those guys do it. But let's just drop old Jeb off here. Up, dorsal balcony. Boing. Old Jebediah here. Can land. Oh! Seriously, Jeb, that wasn't that hard of a landing. Get back up. Dust yourself off. All right, there's Jeb. He's on the moon and he loves it. He is going to go ahead and plant a flag. Plant that flag. Jeb, give me a flag on the moon. And it is going to be... Any visual mods? Yes, some visual mods. This one is not Astronomer's Visual Mech. This is the Renaissance compilation. So the site lane is going to be Boot Camp Hype. Donors, thank you. Whoa, donors, thank you. And I'm going to put all the donor names in here. If you've donated every time I land, you get your name on a flag. That's what I usually do. K Captain Flapjack, I appreciate you. It also gives me an excuse to read your name again. Globo the Mad. Like mad like crazy or just like mad like angry? Like which mad is that? R2B Anime with a donation in there. There you go. We've got Lego Master 14 already. Bing, there you go. We've got Gene. Again, Gene, thank you so much for that. I really do appreciate you. Pale, got you as well. Burp, there you go. We've got EPD 2005, right like that. There you go. We've got Nubius Maximus. I should not put this on here because I'm not going to let him do this to me. He's already too awesome. Rob Sonic. There you go. I've got Veru Plays. Veru, I need to highlight that video for you, man, don't I? Next time you ask me, I'm just going to have to do it live on the stream. And Kibo89. Guys, I really do appreciate the support. Thank you so much. Jebediah, posing with the flag. He should actually pose with his rocket. He should pose with the Kerbin in the background. Look at that. If you're wondering how I do that, that's middle click that allows you to move the camera like that. High five, Jeb. High five. Wait. Yeah, there. That's more slapping in the side of the head. I am more asking this in the side of the head. Just like that. The reflecting stars are fake. I know, they are fake. The reflecting stars are fake. Maxwell, we've been looking at that. We've been talking about that, but we haven't gotten around to it yet. That's probably a beginning of the year sort of thing. Right there, old Jebediah, the awesome thing, since the moon is tidally locked with Kerbin, it'll always have that view of Kerbin. The sun will move round and round, but Kerbin will always be right on the horizon from this flag right here. It's really cool. It's really cool. Let's get her on home, because I did say that I would do a, I would say that I would do a, this right here. I did say I would do a giveaway when I got home. Maybe I should do the giveaway right now. Maybe I should do the giveaway right now. I think I'll do the giveaway right now. I appreciate everyone. It's a fake. I do appreciate right now everybody watching me. What do we got going on right now? We've got a... We've got... 422 viewers. I love it. I do love it. Excelente. That is outstanding. I've got quite a few. So here's what we're going to do. Time out. You can't enter yet. As you watch Boot Camp today, if you stick with me, you're going to earn Kerbal Space Academy credits. When you earn Kerbal Space Academy credits, you can use them for awesome things like giveaways. What I'm going to do, I'm going to start a raffle. You are going to use the tickets, or you're going to use the credits that you earn to enter this raffle. When you use the credits that you enter in this raffle, each ticket you buy is going to cost you 5 credits. You'll be able to buy a maximum of 5 tickets in this first raffle. Every 5 minutes you watch me, you get 1 credit. So if you watch me for 25 minutes, you get 1 raffle entry. Since we've been going for about an hour, most of you, even if you're brand new to the stream, should have 2 raffle tickets. That's why at the beginning of the stream here, we're going to make the maximum tickets 5. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead. Loki, even if you have KSP, you can give it away to a friend. Get somebody else excited about space. Get somebody else excited about Kerbal Space Program. You can give it away to a friend. You can totally do that. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bring up my bot. I'm going to start the raffle. Tickets are going to cost you 5. You're going to need to have Steam, and you're going to have to be okay with giving me your email address in order to get this gift, because it is a Steam gift that I send you via email. That is what's going on. It's going to be a KSP Steam gift for a full copy of the game. Even if you already have it, you can win it, you can give it to somebody else. Get somebody else excited about it. Tickets are going to cost you 5. You're going to be able to buy a maximum of 5. In order to buy them, you're going to type !! Ticket space with the number. !! Ticket space with a number. That's how many tickets you're going to buy. And you can check it by typing !! Credits. If you have parentheses next to your credit balance, that's how many you've entered into the thingy. That's how many things that you need. That is how many things that you need. CK forever. The rocket will free man from his retaining chains, the chains of gravity which still tie him to this planet. It will open him to the gates of heaven. Wernher von Braun. That is a great quote, CK Forever. I really do appreciate that. Thank you for sharing that. I had never heard that before, but that is an amazing quote. If the rocket will, or it says it, will free man from his remaining chains, the chains of gravity which still tie him to the planet. It'll open him to the gates of heaven. That is a great quote. Thank you for that. And thank you for the donation as well. Wow. Thank you, CK. That's like awesome, honestly. I'm going to start the raffle right now. 5 and 5, yeah. There you go. The raffle is now open. You can buy tickets to the raffle now. Every 25 minutes of watching, you get one. You get one ticket entry. It costs you 5 credits to get one ticket. Who said, that was Werner von Braun is what I got there. That was Werner von Braun. I can't read chat anymore. You have until the time that this rocket touches down on the surface of Kerbin to enter this raffle. As soon as this rocket splashes down to the oceans of Kerbin, I'm quitting this raffle. That is what we're doing. That is what we're doing. It's credits with a K. It's credits with a K. Ticket spam go. Ticket spam go. It's not raffle 5. It's ticket 5. It's ticket. Tickets 5. Tickets 5. Is it ticket or tickets? I don't know. I'm not going to read this anymore. Old Jebediah here. We're going to go out of screenshot mode. We're going to turn on his jetpack by pressing R. We're going to fly up here. Here, turn on your light as well. Let us fly over to Zahir. Let us... No. Dorsal battery. Okay. Got it. Grab it. Get in the rocket. I need to go home. Which way is home? How nice. I can go straight up to get home. That's amazing. So let's just go straight up and get home. Staging's good. Delta V, check. If I can't get home on 2190, I'll eat my hat. 3, 2, 1. Throttle up. There's a good liftoff. We're going to go straight on up. We're going to orient dorsally. That looks great. Right like that. Look at that. That is freaking amazing right there. That is amazing. Lee Mercadia. Moon hype. Great job, Doss. Have some Dr. Pepper on me. I will, Lee Mercadia. Thank you for that support. I really do appreciate it. Is all I can say is that I really do appreciate it. I'll get you on the next flag. Kibo89 was the donation there, so I will get you and a CK Forever on the next flag. Thank you for the support, Lee Mercadia. Let me pay attention to this. I need to burn probably this way a little bit. Is that moving my armor correctly? Yeah, it is. Amazing. Okay, let's just burn. Let's go home. I know you guys want to enter the raffle, so I'm just going to burn. I'm going to get this done. Which way is prograde? Retrograde? Now that looks good. All right. I am going to always, always, always eject myself from the moon to go home by going to the left. When I'm on the map screen. If I've got Kerbin in the background, if I've got the moon right here, going to the left is retrograde to the moon's direction of travel around Kerbin. And by ejecting myself to the left, right like this, I will be able to go home. I'm coming home. Tell the world my periaps is decreasing. It's going to go into atmosphere. And that right there is me going home. I don't know the rest of the words of that song. Let's get this done. I'm going to time warp again. Let's do it from here so we can see it. Whoa, buddy! Those stars are so pretty. Those stars are just pretty. That's all I can say about it. Where's the moon, though? Should be straight below us. Goodbye, moon, as opposed to good night, moon. Ah, yes. Let's see here. We're going away. Let me check the chat, see if I missed anything. Keep to your words, I will. What is the raffle for? A full copy of KSP Wizok, KSP Kamuchi, and Spartan, and Sare, and everybody. Did I miss anybody? Who else is here right now? Thank y'all for the help. I do appreciate my mods. My stream would be not possible if I didn't have people helping me out with the moderation. It would not be possible if I didn't have people helping me out with the moderation. I really do appreciate you guys. I can never say enough. Let's see here. please keep it family friendly. If not, we have buttons. Nice. I'm reading my chat. How much is I got that one? Just looking for questions. I'm reading chat. How goes it? Pink Owlcup, man. I'm sorry I missed you. I think you came in when I was doing the landing or something like that. Or we were talking about the raffle giveaway. Dude, Pink Owlcup, again, thank you for your service, man. I'm gonna say that every time I see you because you're awesome. Thanks for stopping by my stream. I do appreciate you. What is this? Should be evening time over your side of the pond, isn't it? I think it's evening time, I think. Yeah. Thanks again for stopping by. Please add a quote. Turtle Gaming, the mods. The mods will add the quotes. You've been playing for years. Never click surface mode for a landing. You should always click surface mode for a landing. Are those flag sites synced on a cloud or network so the players can see? Are the flag sites? J Spaceman, not in the stock game. Not in the stock game. The flag sites are not synced on a cloud or network. If that was the case, we'd be spelling things on the moon and we'd have to delete half of them. I'm just watching Kerbin here. I'll put it in screensaver mode for y'all, honestly. While I get caught up with chat. That is the wrong side. Oh, I can't really... There you go. That's a good screensaver mode. I'm still going through here. I know about DMP. Some sort of interplanetary boot camp. Jackal Persol, I do entire streams on interplanetary. I will be doing a stream on interplanetary transfers either Monday or Tuesday. Either Monday or Tuesday. It's Pale Rider. Okay, it was Pale Rider that was donor. Sapphire Orchid, thank you. Thank you. I didn't see that pop up, but Pale Rider, thank you for the support. Let me say your entire name. Maxwell, please don't spam the things. If you've got something to say, say it once. I will scroll back and see it eventually. Question Das, when am I going to get a subscribe button? That's up to Twitch, not me. Das, I'm going to the moon and going to get returned for the rest of the... Yeah, heck yeah. Sleepy Hipster Space Travel. Good luck with your mission. Exynth. Love the new contracts. You have a reason to do this. I love the skybox you got going on there. You have a reason to put a space station in orbit. I agree. The new contracts actually pay you to put a specifically designed space station in orbit. Have any visual mods? I do. I'm using the Renaissance. How do you get all of those camera angles? Z-Test 2K6. Hold down the middle mouse button and move the mouse. The middle mouse button plus moving the mouse will get you those other camera angles. Making hummus. I think I've caught up. I remember seeing this stuff. And we're about... Is Planet Shy what makes the surface look good? I'm not sure what it is. I better start paying attention here. Let's see here. Because we are coming into Kerbin hot at 1.5 kilometers per second right now. Let me check my trajectory. Trajectory is looking good. I should have come in a little bit more of an angle. We're going to splash down to the ocean, it looks like. Time Warp's going to take care of us for us. Whoa, buddy! There you go. Kill that Time Warp. And we are going to go ahead and flip on around here. Remember, we're coming in at 3 kilometers per second now. Isn't gravity a funny thing? The inverse square of the radius is how quickly gravity increases. Wow, are we actually going to hit that little island? I don't know, we might. When this rocket splashes down, the raffle closes. Is homework for all? No, Bloodless Hacker. Homework is for Sandbox. The homework is for the Sandbox mode, and I will be talking about the homework in great detail. Look at that. You see that? That is energy being bled off. We are converting our speed, our orbital velocity, into heat energy. Heat and light, actually. Heat and light. We are converting that orbital energy into heat and light. That is why we are slowing down. We are coming in at an angle like this. That happens in real life, too. It's called shock or compression heating. Looking good, though. There's a little bit of a sonic boom. Excellent. And then as my velocity continues to decrease, that's looking good. Ain't nobody needs that stage anymore. Later. And I'm going to go ahead, and I really should be going about 100, but I'm going to pop that chute. And we're going to come in for this landing. As soon as this thing splashes down, we're donezo. We're donezo. Deadly G-Force. You're right, Steven Seagal. What did I get there? I'll tell you. I hit 14.5 Gs. Again, that was a very simple reentry. That was not an accurate reentry. You are correct. That would smash any human. 15G hype is right. Let me keep seeing what's going on here. Let me see what's going on here. Yes. Does DOS work with the dev for this game? Matt Captain, I do not. I just love this game and I want to support the devs. Question. The homework of Bloodless Hacker, the homework is for sandbox mode. Does surface mode give your velocity towards the surface? Yes, towards and across the surface. Scipation. Towards and across the surface is what surface mode gives you. Look at this. He could swim to shore. Bloosh! There was a big old sploosh somewhere around there. As soon as this touches down, raffle's over. Question. Is there any reason people use multiple small tanks as well as one large one, such as two 200 versus 100? SG Sooner Dead, sometimes you don't have those parts unlocked, so you can't use them if you're in career mode. Also, using multiple tanks gives you a little bit more fine control over the fueling of it. Whenever you're using the stock tweakables to transfer fuel around, or in the VAB, you're tweaking the amount of fuel. You get a little bit more resolution over the exact amount of fuel in the tank if you use the smaller tanks. Also, If you've got them in two different stages, you're doing drop tanks, that would be an obvious reason to use different size tanks, so you could drop off dead tankage weight, which you don't want to carry with you. Is it possible to still bend stuff to build stuff on the moon, Matroyer? Yes, it is absolutely possible. You got 160 meters, folks. Plan KSP tried to land on the moon with instruments only, just stranded Jeb on the surface. Instruments only, IVA? IVA mode? That is absolutely what's going on. Stinky Peach, we're going to go over instructions on installing add-ons and mod. That is something that I stream. How long after you finish streaming were you able to get it on YouTube? Lego Master, it takes me a couple days. Here comes Carbon, hit the brakes. I didn't have to. Caboose, thank you for the donation the other day, by the way. I didn't have to hit the brakes. Physics did it for me. We're about to splash down. What does surface mode change on the nav ball? It shows you your velocity towards the surface, taking into account the rotation of the planet. A little off topic, it splashed down. I'm giving you some extra time. When would you launch to rendezvous with the ship in orbit? Waverunner, that's a great question. Launch when it's over Kerbal, India. I do entire streams on orbital rendezvous and docking. I do. Kerbal, India, it's the first continent to the left. It's the little thing that looks like India that sticks down if you're in LKO. Launching your rocket as the target passes over LKO, or passes over Kerbal, India, is the time to do it. Did I miss anything else? I think I've got everything else. You just bought KSP as a Christmas gift for your dad, Snuggly Squid. That's amazing. Ad quote, that crater looks delicious. I'm going to land in it. Did I say that? I think I did say that. Thanks, Edward Kohler. I didn't do anything. It was all shoots and physics. Let me get the followers. OTRAZ, LOL Ender Falacion. LOL Ender Falacion. Or Falazion. Thanks for the follow. D Man number 2, thank you for the follow. Dismo, High Ruler, thank you. Stinky Peach, I appreciate you. Nacho Ninja, that sounds delicious. Dr. Eisman, thank you. Ahmed Warum. Ahmed Warum, thanks for the follow. Omni Vuong. That looks Vietnamese. ZA, I remember I got you. I'm all caught up on the follows. I appreciate the follows. I appreciate the follows. LOL, what'd you say? What'd you say? At Dos Valdez, second time. I didn't see the first time, and I didn't see anything else you said, but welcome to the stream. What else do we have here? What else do we have here? Wouldn't recommend Kerbal, India for a deorbit spot. You need to use the mountain range a couple times over. It's going to cost you a lot more Delta V to deorbit at the KSC. This right here, Jebediah, has splashed down. Folks, I said when Jeb splashed down, I'm closing the raffle, and guess what? It's closed right now. The raffle is officially closed. The raffle is officially closed. Ticket raffle closed. 114 viewers entered with a total of 468. 468 tickets. The second pronunciation. Oh, the second pronunciation. Oh, thank you, thank you. Sorry, I didn't get the context. I didn't get the context. Dude, welcome to the stream. Lolinder Falacian, I think is the second one I said. I think. But thank you so much for following me. It is time to draw the winner. To draw the winner. Did Kujuman miss the raffle? No! Kujuman, you're hilarious. It is time to draw the winner of the raffle right now. May the RNGesus be ever smiling down upon your digital personage. Good luck, y'all, because right now, the winner is of the first copy of KSP. Bring! Shuriken! 5 tickets and a 1.1% chance to win. Following the stream for a long time. Shuriken, you are regular. Congratulations! Say something in chat. Say something in chat. Does one of my mods want to do the handouts? I've actually got codes to hand out. Can one of my mods handle the handouts? Does anybody want to volunteer for that? Hit me up in Skype right quick, guys, mods. And let's get the handouts sorted. Let's see there. Let me do this. Skype it up. There we go. Scott Manley is apparently... Okay, well, sending images apparently. Yes. Mods, if we can hop over... Anyone want to hand out the codes? I've got the codes right here. Let me paste it over here. Shuriken! Say something in chat, Shuriken. Did you say anything yet? Where you at, Shuriken? Did I see anything from you? Where you at? You gotta say something. Shuriken! Where you is? Say something in chat. Poor favor. Just one second, I'm typing. I need to go and grab this and do this. Let me handle this right quick. There we go. Not yet. It can't be. Shuriken, where are you, Shuriken? How did you enter the raffle and leave? How did you do that? Shuriken, where are you? Psychro Hype. Psychro sent him. Psychro won in the raffle yesterday. Kirby to Shuriken. Kirby to Shuriken. Come in, Shuriken. He's in the viewer list. I know Shuriken is here. We're going to get it sent to him. Let me do this. Where is... We're doing this. He's passed out. He is passed out. Let me finish the raffle right here, and then we're going to go over to boot camp proper, and we are going to learn about everything in the game. Shuriken, where are you? Good night, Irene. Where are you? Shuriken, please. Please. Please be here. Shuriken. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Shuriken, come on. Please show up. Please, 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 please show up, Shuriken. Let's see what we've got here. You do have to be present to win. You do have to be present to win, guys. I really do. It kills me. It kills me, but you do have to say something in chat within 5 minutes. Within 5 minutes. Within 5 minutes. Let's see here. You gotta say something within 5 minutes. Where are the key? There we go. Alright. There you go. He's here! You're here! You won, Shuriken! Heck yeah, you made it! You made it. You made it. Who should I say? Who should I say? Who should I say? Yes. So, let's see here. Kamuchi, can you do it? Cam, can you pass him out? For now, so I can say your name, so I can say your name. There you go. Is that cool? Is that cool? You need to, Shuriken. You need to. Survey says you need to. The winner. There you go. Yeah, there you go. That'll work right there. That'll go. I'm just going to say it. I'm just going to say it. Or Sarion, do you want to do it? Sarion could do it. Or Cam. I just want to make sure I say to Mesh's the right place. Let's see. I'm getting this worked out. I'm getting this worked out. Dude, sure, Keen. I'm so glad you didn't pull a Psychro. Take it easy, Lego Master. We'll get this up here. We'll click at the face and redeem page for Steam. Wait, what? There you go. There you go. Sarion, how about you do it? For now, you do it, Sarion. You do, or yeah, Sarion's got it. All right, folks. Shuriken, you need to message Sarion TX. You need to message Sarion TX. Sarion TX will coordinate to get you your key so that you can load it up right now. If you don't have it, you can give it away to a friend or whatever you want to do. This way, with one of my mods handling it, we didn't work that out in advance, but now we did. Thanks for y'all being patient. With one of my mods handling it, you'll get the copy faster. It'll be a Steam key. It'll be a Steam key, and it'll toss it over there. Wave Runner, you're looking for launch. That's what you're looking for right there. That's what you're looking for. Excellent. Guys, Sarion is going to handle the giveaways for now. Shuriken, you are good to go. You're good to go. He was on a lunch break and literally had to go back to work. I know, Sapphire Orchid. He sent me a message as well. He sent me a message as well. Jeb's taking a bath. We are good to go. Shuriken, congratulations on your win. Let us reset the raffle. And our next checkpoint is going to be the next time that we get into orbit. The next time that we get into orbit, I'm going to be giving away another copy of KSP. another copy of KSP. Yes, Captain Flapjack, you're fine. The next time I get into orbit will be the next giveaway. That was the first of 5 giveaways that I'm doing today. That is what we're doing. So let's get Jeb recovered here and let us go learn about the rockets. Let us go learn about the rockets. There we go. All right, we're good to go. We're good to go. You don't get any refunds. You don't get any refunds. You don't get any refunds. All right, there you go. Sure, Keen, just say, I won, I won, I won. Just say, I won, I won, I won. What's the mod called with the Delta V? That is what we're going to talk about. Welcome to Kerbal Boot Camp proper. We've just done a demonstration mission. We spent about an hour doing that demonstration mission. We are now going to talk. We are now going to talk about Kerbal Space Program. And the first thing I'm going to do right here is show you the things in Kerbal Space Program that you need. There is one mod that I think you should have because it pulls back the curtain. It exposes the numbers behind the game. The game is using the numbers. Why don't you have the numbers as well? You saw my rocket in the VAB. You saw that I had the little window that was reading out the Delta V and the thrust to weight ratios. That did all sorts of stuff for me here in the VAB. You saw me using it as I was flying this craft to the moon. It's called Kerbal Engineer. And it shows you so many useful things. Why did that rocket get to the moon and land and come back home successfully on the first try? Because Kerbal Engineer. I mean, I'm an okay pilot, I guess. But because I designed the rocket using Kerbal Engineer and I understood what the numbers were. So if you're playing along, and you want to learn KSP, what I want you to do is download a mod called Kerbal Engineer. I am actually going to show you how to download and install this mod. I am going to do that for you right now. Let's get that done. I am going to come over here and make sure that I've got everything that I need. Excuse me. Make sure that I've got everything I need. And I'm going to show you how to install mods in the game. This is not true for every single mod in the world, but this is true for most of the more basic mods. So let me do this. I'm going to change over to a web page. Let's see. Let's just do monitor capture. Why not? There we go. Let me open a new web page. New window. Excellent. I'm going to go to... I'm actually just going to click on that link right there from Cybotech. Excellent. Thank you for putting that up right when I needed it. Here is Kerbal Engineer's webpage. This is a link. This is actually on CurseForge. It's not their webpage specifically, I guess. But this is a link to Kerbal Engineer. Once you find a mod and you download the mod, you need to get it installed. There's a lot of great ways to find mods. The forums. The forums is a great place to start. Go to the forums. Go to the add-ons. Look, I'll actually do it right quick. I'll actually just go to forums. forum.kerbalspaceprogram.com like this. I'll just click on that. There you go. Oops, invalid form specified. My bad. I typed it wrong. There you go. Go to forums. Scroll down to add-on releases. Those are mods, mod releases. Click on mod releases, add-on releases. Click on this community mods and plugins library. There are so many mods to shop around from here. There are so many mods in this list. If you're new to the game, don't get all the mods. Start off learning the basics before you start crashing your game by installing 100 mods. But from here, I could actually find old Kerbal Engineer. I could find Engineer. Oops, if I spelled it correctly. Engineer. There's one. There's two. Kerbal Engineer, I could click on that. That would actually bring me over to the Engineer Redux page. I could scroll down to make sure that I get this Kerbal test release, the public test release. Click on that, and that's going to end me up on that page over at Kerbal Forge, SourceForge, actually, CurseForge, Kerbal Forge. That's hilarious. DOS is a clicker hero, confirmed. We know that. Sometimes I stream it at the beginning of my stream. From here, look how easy it is to install this mod. I'm just going to click on download. And when I click on download, it's going to download a zip file. when I have the zip file downloaded, I can actually open the zip file, and I get something that looks a lot like this. You see that? I know there's a little bit of delay with my voice. It isn't. When I do the full stream thing like this, it does desync a little bit. Sorry, not a lot I can do about it. I am then going to go and find the folder where Kerbal Space Program is installed. There we go. Games, probably. Kerbal, oops, I went to the wrong one. I need to go to C. I need to go to Games. I need to go to Kerbal Win Beta 9.0. Your path may be a little bit different. Your path may be just a little bit different here. There we go. I'm just cleaning this up so you can see it. So my path, I actually named the folder this, KSP_win_beta090. That was the name that I gave it. If you've installed KSP, you may have a little bit different path. And if you have a Steam link, if you actually do it on Steam, you'll have it in your Steam, what is it? Your Steam library or something like that. Your Steam library like that. Yeah, my voice does desync a little bit when I stream full stream desktop with this, with a bazillion resolution or whatever it is I run. So all I need to do here is take Kerbal Engineer. Do you see this Kerbal Engineer folder over here? And I need to drag it into this game data folder. Like that. See how it says copy to game data? You see Kerbal Engineer and you just drag it over to the game folder? If you know how to drag a folder to another folder in Windows, you can do this. Mac is pretty much the same. Absolutely, Nightcore Man, absolutely. As long as it's family friendly and related, that is absolutely correct. So go ahead and toss it over to GameDaddy. You let it go. I've already got it installed, so I would have to tell it to do this, copy and replace. If you don't have it installed yet, it'll just go. That right there, is it going to crash out on me? Yeah. I would let that finish. I'm just going to click cancel. But dragging that thing over so that Kerbal Engineer is in GameData is all you have to do. And if you bust open my GameData, you should actually see Kerbal Engineer right like that. You should see Kerbal Engineer right like that in the GameData folder. That's all it takes. You download a mod, you drag the folder over into the game data folder. Most mods work that way. Some of the more complicated mods maybe don't work that way. If it's all the environmental visual enhancements and that sort of stuff, it can be more complicated. But the majority of parts that, or the majority of mods that you install, that's all that you have to do. That is all that you have to do right there. It's really simple to do that. And again, did we get the Steam? Thank you, Sapphire Orchid. Thank you. Steam Apps Common Kerbal Space Program. Thank you for putting that link up. That is what it is. It may be in a different drive. It may be different for you. But get over to where you have KSP installed. You see KSP.exe. Find that game data folder, and dragging and dropping mods into that game folder is how you install it. That is how you install it. Yeah, I have empirical as evidence, Hydrodryron. I do have empirical evidence. So, that is all you have to do to install mods. I recommend that you download and install Kerbal Engineer absolutely positively. Because now we're going to go back to the VAB, and we're going to learn about using Kerbal Engineer. So let me go ahead and go out of full screen, like that. Now I can close down these windows. I don't need them anymore. I can do that. There's my game. All right, excellent. So now we're back in the VAB, and we see Kerbal Engineer. And we see Kerbal Engineer giving us all sorts of information about the rocket. If you install Kerbal Engineer, like I said, you've got Kerbal Engineer in the game data folder, and you don't see it, press the backslash. Backslash key will actually show and hide it. That's what's going on here. So let's see here. Did I miss anything? I don't think I missed anything. I'm going to start with a new craft. I'm going to drink. And as I build this rocket, of course, dude, Shimmy the JJ, man, you know that you are welcome. You know that you're welcome, folks. And I hope we got Shimmy a JJ a streamer link. If you haven't followed Shimmy the JJ yet, if you love Kerbal Space Program, you gotta follow Shimmy. You gotta follow Shimmy. Dude, Shimmy, thanks for coming by as well. Thank you. Whoa, Sandbros is here. What is going on, Sandbros? Long time no see. Is it the entire, like, family? Is it everybody watching Kerbal Space Academy right now? If it is, Sandbro family, what's going on? And Sandbro Actual, I appreciate what you do. I do appreciate what you do. Folks, thank y'all so much for watching. Sandbros, you guys are awesome. Thanks for stopping by. Yes, it is. It's everybody. Sandbros Actual, we know what we're talking about there. I appreciate all y'all. Thank you so much for stopping by. You're in Texas. Oh, you're in Texas for Christmas. Nicely done. Ah, yes. Outstanding. Streamer the JJ. Let me scroll back. I'm going to take a drink right quick. We're going to get to building this rocket. I have an awful lot of light on the side of my face, so let me fix that right quick. There you go. Much better. Much better. Let me scroll through chat and see if I missed anything. The rapiers make you cry, right, Top Hat Dragon? Shimmy's a cheater. I think I'm going to elevate Shimmy to Cheater McCheaterson status. Let me see if I missed anything. Outside the VAB. Yes, Zagonos. Yes. Get Kerbal Engineer 1.0. Don't get Kerbal Engineer 0.6. Because with 1.0, you don't need to put the part on it. You don't need to put the part on it. You don't need to put the part on it. Let's see here. Let me go up. With Kerbal Engineer 1, it's partless. You don't have to have it on there. Let me read the chat and take a drink right quick. Loki, no, I don't do song requests on my channel. I don't do song requests. All right, look at your boat, Night Corman. That's actually a really cool looking boat, man. Nicely done. I'm going to read chat here. Sanchez. Astronomer's Vigil pack I don't think is officially updated for 0.90 yet. It is complicated, and I can't go into detail on that during boot camp. It is very complicated, but if you come to my chat when I'm offline, there are always people here who can help you out with that stuff. Let's see here. I'm reading the chat right quick. Yes, you can send photos. Severtron, okay, good deal. All bad, welcome. I am alive, yes. There's my clicker heroes. I am on occasion going to scroll back through my chat and make sure I answered all the questions, guys. That's what the red highlighted things are. The next giveaway is going to be when we get into orbit for the first time here. The second time. Can we do a mission to ELU? No, we're at boot camp right now, Turtle Gaming. We're not doing custom missions right now. We can. I mean, I could, but that's not what I'm going to do at boot camp. Vice Rosetta was shaken. What's the mod call with the Delta V? It's Kerbal Engineer. Silver, I hope you saw how to install it right there. Your hours. Yeah, they got you there. KSP Kamuchi got you there. Hours are still the same. The hours will stay the same, but the credits will go down when you spend them on tickets. I remember he was on lunch break. Time for you to go, Lego Master. I remember reading that. That means that I'm all caught up with chat here. See, it doesn't take very long. And hey, guys, asking me to do missions like, can you teach us how not to auger into Tylo? That's a little off topic. And when you highlight it and stuff like that, it actually kind of hides the real questions that people have. So yes, can I teach you how not to auger into Tylo? It's not hard. It's very easy to do. But I'm not going to do it during boot camp. So if you could keep it relevant to boot camp topics, I really would appreciate it. And if you keep spamming things that aren't related to boot camp, the mods will take care of it. I appreciate you. But let's keep it related to boot camp here, and let's not abuse the highlighting, please. Let's see here. Will you do shooter raffles? Hingo. Nah, you're right, Hingo. I like to give people time to go in, but if we do shorter raffles, you're right. The AK problems. Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I usually do shorter raffles than that. I think I'm all caught up. Where are we going next? We're going to the moon. And Homeless Al, yes, I can teach you rovers. I do entire streams on rovers, and I've got some stuff on YouTubes. I really do appreciate y'all, though. Teflon Mike, dude, get Teflon Mike a follow as well. What are space lanes usually used for in this game? Being awesome, really, Zeta. Really awesome. Can I read a Twitch message I sent? I had something in stream, and I answered it in there just to let you know. Pro Combat. I think I know what it's about, and I think we're good to go. I've got caught up with chat. So let's start talking about this rocket here. And let me do that. And let me do this over here. I don't have any new Twitch messages. I'm not going to read any more messages for now. But I don't see... I responded to you, Pro Combat, yesterday. Alright, no more messages for now. Let's talk about rockets. And let's talk about what we need to do in order to launch rockets. Excuse me. Yes, I will, Philo. I will definitely be doing that. Yes, let's do all of these things. You guys, those are some great questions. I can teach how to make planes in KSP. That's a different stream, though. Das, can you teach how to manage acceleration during ascent? Absolutely, Sherman. I can do that. Will I be going over to use the Delta MeVap? Absolutely, Philo. I will do that. Or Philo. And what is the force button on the left from the place button? That is the redo the root node. I'll show you what that is. But let's talk about rockets. It's time to actually start this. Let's talk about rockets. Right now, we've got a command pod here. We know that the number one thing that I need with a rocket is some ability to control it. Some command and control capabilities. I can do that in Kerbal Space Program in a couple different ways. I can either have a pod on it that has a Kerbal inside of it who thinks that he's moving the rocket by pressing the controls and that sort of stuff, or I can have a probe core like this little Stay Putnik. Either one of those things will give me command and control authority over the rocket. If I try to make a rocket and it is just a fuel tank like that and an engine like this and no command or control authority, I will not be able to launch this rocket. It will not go anywhere because there's nothing on the rocket to say turn the engine on. There's nothing on the rocket to say turn to the east. There's nothing on the rocket that says spin a certain direction. There is nothing to command this rocket. So usually when you start a rocket, you start off with some sort of command and control authority. Right there, this little pod is what I'm going to use. I also know that on a rocket, I need an engine. So if I take an engine, like this LVT-45 liquid fuel engine, and I put it on the rocket, I will need some way to push myself around. However, I'm missing a very critical component here. An engine doesn't just like magically use fairy dust to make your rocket go places. You're actually going to need a fuel tank. So we could put a little fuel tank on there, right like that, and that right there is a basic rocket. In fact, with command and control, fuel, and a way to use that fuel, this rocket will fly around. Let's see how that works. I'm going to launch it, and let's go drive it around. Let's see what happens here. I actually don't know. I am going to pause reading chat for just a second, and I'm going to talk about the rocket here, and then I'll go back to the rocket whenever I get a chance. That's pretty right there. Jebediah Kerman's in there. Let us go ahead and make it daytime. So, whoa, buddy! A little too fast there. No, not that fast. Gosh. Come on. Okay, there! Okay, now it's daytime. That's better. So like I said, we've got command authority, we've got fuel, and we've got a way to use that fuel to make the rocket go. That means we can launch it. We brought it out here to the launch pad. We've got a couple different things. I know I forgot all sorts of stuff. We've got quite a different things. We've got quite a few different things here. We can see up here at the top my altitude, 76 meters. Why is that not zero? That's sea level. The sea is out there. We're 76 meters above sea level. Because look, see, you got the elevation of the pad. You got a couple different things. We can see the nav ball down here. If you're ever on the screen, you don't have the nav ball. It looks like that. You can actually click on it to expand it right like that. The nav ball shows me a lot of different things. It shows me my direction, my heading, my bearing, whatever you want to call it. It shows me my velocity. It shows me my acceleration. It shows me my throttle settings. See how right now I'm throttled all the way down. It shows me whether or not SAS and RCS are engaged. I'll talk about what those are in just a second. But the nav ball is very important. The nav ball is very important. That's down there at the bottom of the screen. You can see right now we're pointing straight up, so we've got a big blue nav ball with no brown ground on it anywhere. Up in the left-hand corner, we've got the time warp. As you saw the sun go round and round and round and round and round, that's because I was actually warping time. In KSP, in space travel in general, space travel takes a long time. You wouldn't want to do a real-time moon mission in KSP, because you would have to like sit there for days playing the game. That would be super boring. You don't want that. You don't want that. Thanks, Commander Solo. Commando Solo. I got it. You're good. You can time warp. And you can time warp in a couple different ways. You can either click on these up here. The more arrows you have, the more time warp you've got. Or you can press the period and comma keys on the keyboard. You see how I can make it go up and down? I can do that by pressing period and comma. You will use that all the time in Kerbal Space Program. It's very important to know where that is. What else do we have? Oh, down in the corner, we can see our staging right now. This is a very simple rocket, so it's only got one stage, one engine. When we get into more complex rockets, I'll talk more about it. You can see my roll, pitch, and yaw authority. See how I can change that around down here in the lower... See, you got the cursor down here to the lower left. You can see the control authority that I'm using on the rocket right now. Anything else important? Oh, you've got me. I'm over here. And then right next to me is Jebediah. You get pictures of your Kerbals. They will actually change their expressions based on what's going on in the game. If you're about to kill them, they'll be concerned about it, usually. Where are the keys on the screen? That is a great question. Let's put the keys up there. There's the keys. Thank you. Good catch, the filler. You can actually see, as I was pressing things, I've got a thing that I made that allows me to show you what keys I'm pressing. So right there, you see the overlay and you see my keys right here. As I press it, you can see what happens. That is a very useful thing for me. Anyways, let's actually fly this rocket. The first thing you need to do when you get to the rocket is throttle it up. There's a couple ways you can control your throttle in the game. You can either hold down the shift key to throttle up and hold down the control key to throttle down. Do you see it moving right here? It's like on the nav ball, on the other side of the nav ball. Do you see it going up and down? That is my throttle control. Shift increases my throttle and control decreases my throttle. I can also press the Z key. If I press the Z key, it'll slam it into full throttle, the same as flooring it in your car. If I press the X key, it'll completely cut your throttle and bring it all the way down to zero. So Z is full throttle, X is zero throttle, Shift is throttle up, Control is throttle down. Those are the stock key bindings. So what I want to do when I take off is throttle up. In order to do that, I just press the Z key. The next thing that I can do here, I want to turn on something called SAS. SAS stands for Stability Augmentation System, or Sickness Avoidance System, or whatever you want to call it. Stability Augmentation System. SAS is something that attempts to keep the rocket pointing in the direction you've already got it pointed. So right now it's pointed straight up, and if I turn on SAS, the SAS system will try to keep the rocket going straight up. I will actually press the T key, and you can see right there on the nav ball. Look, it's right there. When I press the T key, you see that light go on and off? The T key will turn on and off SAS. When the light is enabled like that, that means it's on. When it's off, that means it's off. Also, you've got a couple things over here. I'll go over those in detail. Just make sure that top green one that is the stability assist is highlighted. The next thing that I almost always want you to do is click up here. When I click up there, that is going to make that panel stick open. That allows me to monitor my resources. Do you see it right there above the chat? I clicked on that little fuel tank, and that sticks that little panel open like that so I can see how much fuel and stuff I have. Also, if you've got Kerbal Engineer installed, which you should, you can press the backslash key to bring up Kerbal Engineer. So there's a backslash key right like that. That'll bring up Kerbal Engineer. I really do recommend that you download and install that mod because it will really, really help you out. And I'm going to use it this entire stream to show you what's going on. 3, 2, 1 is a countdown. And the really cool thing about Kerbal Space Program is that to light the rocket and to go into space, you actually press the space bar. So when you press the space bar, the rocket will take off and start to go up. This is, everybody always mistypes DOS as dad, you're right. That rocket wheel right there will start to go up. You see the delta V going down? We're spending that delta V. Delta V is very important, and I'm going to talk to you all about it. You see our fuel going down? Fuel plus engine equals delta V. As the fuel goes down, the delta V also goes down. We're spending it right now. We're going straight up. I know we don't have a chute. I know. Come on, it's a teaching moment. And I can control the rocket by pressing the different keys. Remember I said I could throttle down? I could actually kill the motor by pressing X. I could do a sweet flip by holding down D. Normally you don't do this when you're launching a rocket, by the way. I can point to the east, which is that way, the way the sun came up. I can point to the west, which is towards the mountain, the way the sun came down. I can point to the north. See on the nav ball? Do you see north on the nav ball? That right there is north. I can point to the south. There is south right there. There are a lot of different things that I can do. I've been playing with Engineer for hundreds of hours and I didn't know it had hotkeys. Does it have others? Does it have others? That's the only hotkey I'm aware of, just the backslash to make it show and hide. The backslash to make it show and hide is what I am aware of. Don't know of any other ones. That is why I saw somebody say, I already know how to play KSP. Why am I watching this stream? You've played Engineer for hundreds of hours. Somebody else has played with Engineer for hundreds of hours and has learned something. You may learn something watching this stream, or you could help out other people. No one needs to learn how to kill Jeb. It comes naturally. I can point all sorts of different ways. Do you see what's happening on the nav ball? As I point up like that, so I've got all blue, that rocket is pointing straight up towards the sky. As I flip over and I point straight down, what does the nav ball look like? It's brown. What does that look like? That's also green. But when I point straight down, that means I'm pointing towards the planet or whatever I'm orbiting. If I point towards the N on the line, like that, that means that the rocket is pointing north relative to the surface of the planet. If I go all the way around, that's going to mean that I'm pointing south. Oops, nope, that's east. That right there is south. You see the heading? 180 degrees is south. Whenever you come over here, 270, that's west. If I come all the way to the other side, 90, that's going to be east. The last thing I want you to see here, that's actually me rolling. If I point up like that, do you see that 45, 10, 20, 30, 40, 45? That is going to be at a 45 degree angle relative to horizon. Hopefully you understand the nav ball because Jeb gave his life to teach you about it. Oh my gosh. Jeb gave his life so that you could learn how the nav ball works and how the interface works. Do him justice by remembering the lessons that were just learned. Just kidding, we can revert the flight. Revert to vehicle assembly. In my game, the Kerbals are Cylons. There are many copies. They don't really have a plan. I just kill them all the time. They can be reincarnated, no problem. So you saw we had a problem there with our craft. Our little craft that we made, we had a problem. We didn't have a way to keep Jed from dying. Actually, we did have a way. We could have used the fuel if we hadn't used it all. We could have landed it. Hugs his spirit. A 21 Dr. Pepper salute. In salute of the... Yeah. We'll pour one on the... Wait, that would be my keyboard. I don't want to pour one on the keyboard for Jeb. That would probably kill the stream. Let me drink right quick, though. We needed a way to save Jeb. You've got tons of different parts in here. If you're doing rockets like this, you're almost always going to want to click on the utility tab. Do you see all of these tabs? Do you see how I clicked on the pod tab? And that gave me the pod. I clicked on the fuel tank tab, and that's where I got the fuel tank tab, including the delicious Dr. Pepper fuel tank. That's a mod you can download. I love it. If you click on the engine tab, you can see engines. If you click on the command and control, that shouldn't be labeled command and control. There's no command on here. Way to go, squad. This is control authority. There is no command here whatsoever. That is completely mislabeled. That is a bug. A 23 favor salute. I love it. Where do they miss this? There's no command at all on this tab. There is only control. Very interesting. Very interesting. That should just be a control authority. This tab should be control authority. Very interesting. This right here, structural, that's different structural pieces that I can use. Aerodynamics are wings and nose cones and engines and intakes and that sort of stuff. Utility is utility, like landing gears and fashion lighting and docking ports and solar panels and that sort of stuff. And finally, science, where you've got different science experiments. So you can click on different things in the VAB over there to get them. If you're playing in Sandbox, you'll have all these parts. If you're playing in Career, the parts will be locked until you unlock them, until you research them by using science. We won't go too much into that right now, though. So I was going to go to the utility tab. I was going to grab a parachute. I was going to put it on there. And that right there is a parachute to help me land Jeb. Now the problem is that if I just go launch this rocket, I just slapped on a parachute. Sure, that's all I needed to do. All I needed to do was put a parachute on it, right? Oh no, I did a revert. Hang on a second, let me fix the day. Oh, okay, there we go. Now I'm actually going to recover him right quick. Then I'm gonna put him back out there again. So that it's daytime when we do all of our demonstrations. Let me fix that right quick. Outlaw, don't give it away. Let me launch Jeb again, and let's see what we've got here. I put a chute on it. I have the engine. Remember I said I could come over here? And I could totally... Giving it away, man. Jeez. I could totally throttle up by pressing Z. I could panel lock by clicking up there, right, to lock that panel down so I can see my fuel. And I could SAS engage by pressing T. See how the little SAS light right there came on? And then I could totally just go 3-2-1 space. And the problem is, that doesn't look like a recipe for success. That actually looks like a terrible idea. This is not what we want at all. This is definitely not what we want. Apparently that's a asbestos parachute with some sort of unobtainium lines. This looks like a recipe for hilarity is what it looks like. Wait, Jeb! Chill out! Oh my gosh! But Jeb is okay. Pay attention when you add parts to your rocket. Because in Kerbal Space Program and in real life, we have staging. It has a stable orbit. It has a stable orbit. Jeb made it. Jeb made it. Luke finds it quite funny. Dude, Luke, what's going on, man? We need to play Minecraft sometimes. We really do need to play Minecraft. I've been teaching way too many space academies, but I do appreciate you watching, Luke. And Colin, thanks for watching, guys. We need to fix that. We need to fix that. So let's go back to the VAB where we fix our ships, the vehicle assembly building, and let's fix the problem. The parachute did say Jeb. It happened. This was a terrible idea, says Jebediah Kerman. In Kerbal Space Program, we've got something called staging. And that is the order of operations for your rocket. It's the different things that will happen different during different phases of your rocket's flight or mission. What we can do to fix that in the VAB is minimize chat right quick so you can see it. Let me do this. Bink, bink. Right over here. Do you see over there?